the art of fashion TV, where art, fashion, and music all meet in one place, right here on the Art of Fashion TV. And now, welcome your host, Glenn Donovan!
Hello, and thank you for joining us on the Art of Fashion TV. I'm your host, Glenn Donovan. Hey, today we're going to be doing things a little bit differently. I'm not going to be hosting and interviewing some fashionistas today, but today we're going to be doing the art of acting. So I am going to be joined with a couple actors. I have Danny Dougherty here. He's from a new TV show called Crash the System. It's available to view on Amazon Prime and on Tubi. So we're going to be joined today by a couple of the actors on that TV show, and I'm very happy and excited. Hey,
I'm very excited. Very excited.
Yes, thanks for joining
us. Thanks for being here.
So you got this new show coming out, Crash the System.
Yes.
And I think you were discussing that it was brought to us by Kamal from the Jerky Boys.
Kamal Ahmed from the Jerky Boys. Correct.
Yes.
After he left the Jerky Boys, he became a writer director.
Uh-huh.
And obviously, you know, where I'm from in Yonkers, New York, back in the day, long time ago, the Jerky Boys were very popular.
Yeah, I remember listening to them.
You remember the cassette tapes. You know, that was basically going viral back then.
Yeah.
Even like rappers or, you know, anything, like if you had a tape and it went around everybody, that was going viral.
Right, before any of the internet and stuff, everybody would make copies of a copy, so you get this ratty copy, you could barely hear it, but you got the jokes going on, and it's still like something that you'd be laughing at. I love the Jerky Boys.
They were huge in my neighborhood, so that's how I know of him.
Okay.
So, and, you know, flash forward a few years after that, you know, I was in the embryo stages of becoming a professional actor, and I was just happened to be home, and I was watching his movie.
Mm-hmm. The Jerky Boys.
The Jerky Boys movie. Yeah.
So now we're mainstream.
Yeah.
So we're not going on cassettes. We're going like Hollywood.
They were Metallica, the underground, you know, kings, and then they did the Black Album and went mainstream.
Right. Excellent. Excellent. And you've been in a couple different projects recently, right?
Yes.
One shares my moniker, Ray Donovan.
Yeah. Right?
I'm being Glenn Donovan.
Yeah.
All right, why don't we take a look at one of your scenes? And you're here with John Voight in this one. Give us a little setup on this one.
I will. All right. This is from the last season, season 6, 2019.
Mm-hmm.
The scene is actually... Bunchy and Mickey are ripping off the Hampton Jitney. They are
just robbing a bus.
Robbing a bus.
Okay, and you're there to do that.
No. They're there to do that, but unbeknownst to them, I am a passenger, and I'm not going for it.
Okay.
I get up and I tell them otherwise.
Okay, well, let's take a look at that.
Yeah.
All right, Ray Donovan with Danny Dougherty.
Thank you.
Asshole. Yeah.
Fucking drop it.
I don't want to shoot you, but I will. This ain't even my gun, it's my brother's gun. I'd be really pissed if I kill somebody with it. But I will.
You want to be a hero? I can help you. Or you can live. Drop the fucking gun.
If you shoot me, I'll shoot you back.
Don't two fucking shoot up, Pop.
Shoot them both of them.
Listen, put the gun down, all right? We'll all get out of here.
I'm gonna shoot him.
Don't you fucking shoot nobody, man.
What do you propose we do?
Leave the shit and get off the bus.
No can do, Junior.
Let's go.
I was scared, man.
How many times I told you everything I know?
A movie I did with Ice-T back in 2015.
You believe me, don't you? Please tell me you believe me.
Believe you? Believe? Believe? I believe you're a lying, blood-sucking double-crosser who's so fucking greedy that you ruin everything we built just to make a few extra bucks.
What did you do that for?
He was out of fingers.
So yeah, I mean, that was some good, great, you know, a couple good clips, some of the stuff that you've been in, very exciting.
Thank you.
I mean, it must be exciting to be working with like some really like A-listers. You got John Voight over there.
It's amazing.
If John Voight comes over to you and he says, "Oh, you know, you do pretty good over here," like, you know, like how'd you get so good? What, you know, is that something that he would approach to you or something?
Well, I got a funny story about that.
Yeah.
When we were on the set. I was there for a week back in, I believe it was the summer of 2019.
Mm-hmm.
And I think this was like the second day. So we're in the makeup trailer. You know, he's getting his makeup. I'm getting mine.
Yeah.
You know, something similar to this. A chair was sitting there, and the music is on. We know we're laughing, and he goes, you know, you're a real talented guy. He's like, he goes, where did you study? And I look over, and I said, study? I watch Columbo. and he's like, oh my God, I love it, because he was good friends with Peter Falk.
Oh, okay.
But the reason is because, you know, I come from Yonkers, you know, blue collar background.
Right.
So, you know, I did some acting school per se, you know, like nighttime classes.
Sure.
And all that, but you know, basically it's just like a natural thing. And
yeah.
And as the more parts that I got, it was like kind of like on the job training, you know, mm-hmm. like, so I kind of, you know, the talent part is just like you have to know how to tell a story. It's the mechanics that you have to learn, your eye line and where you have to sit, like that kind of stuff. So he got a real big kick out of that. And like, and going back to what you said, you know, I'm just a regular kid. You know, I started my first foray into show business, so to say, was I was a breakdancer.
Oh,
and
really?
Graffiti writer.
Okay.
You know, that's was my thing. You
yeah.
know what I mean? And that kind of got me used to, not the graffiti part. The graffiti part, you sneak it down in the subway tunnels. But
sure.
But the breakdancing part, you know, it got me used to being in front of a crowd.
Right.
And I got that
a little notoriety.
That
and
notoriety.
A little, yeah, and that feedback.
You know, and it's like that old saying, once you get, you know, the bug, it's always in you.
Sure, sure. Absolutely. You know? Excellent.
And then from there, I went into DJing, you know, so the acting thing. So, but like I said, just to speed it up, it's like, you know, when we're acting, we're on set, I'm doing my thing. It's
yes.
like when I get back to, like, when they're changing the scene and, you know, I'm sitting there and then I come back to me.
Yeah, coming back to Danny.
And then I look over and I'm like, holy crap, is that Al Pacino over there?
Right.
How the hell did I get here?
Right,
like,
right.
What are you doing here?
Yeah, well, it's like a dream, you know, you're working with all these
yeah,
this
I'm
great
like, what
talent.
Are you, what
and
are you
here
doing
I am
here?
There too.
Like, are these people paying me for this?
Yeah, that's awesome. That's know? Awesome. Well,
thank
you always got to start somewhere. That's
yeah,
great.
Absolutely, absolutely.
Okay, we're going to bring on a couple more guests in over here, all right? But I want everybody to check out Crash the System. It's on Amazon Prime, it's on Tubi. We're going to see Danny Dougherty there and a lot of other people. So go check it out.
You sure this is everything?
Yeah, dude.
You mind telling us where you intended on taking these two?
Well, being as to how I was treated by you and your two clown shoe wearing bitches, I was gonna take it to your main competitor, the one who killed Bronca, so that you wouldn't have it.
They're called Optimadium. You should know the name of a company that wants nothing but destruction.
Oh, and your weapon isn't destructive, huh? Turning people into vegetables isn't destructive.
Fell down. I don't know what happened.
Let's go. Some water?
Come on, let me help you up.
Oh, should we get you an ambulance or something?
Oh. You all right, bro?
You all right?
You all right?
Whoa. Relax, bro. Just relax.
All right, thank you. We are back at the Art of Fashion TV, and I'm here with the cast of Crash the System. All right, I'm sitting here with me is Cory Duval, Katheen Wilce, and Stuart Rudin. And joining us on Zoom, we got James, Magda, and Joey right now. Thanks for joining us. Just a little bit of an explanation on your role on the show and kind of like maybe how you got into it, maybe how you met with Kamal a little bit. Can you tell us a little bit about that?
Yes. So I play Gemini, and Gemini is somewhat of like a complex, multi-personality, lost soul. Very scary. But he's got a lot of layers, and I hope those layers are, let me not give you too much information.
It seems like it's hard not to give too much information.
That's the thing, we can't give anything away.
There's lots of layers and lots of info we don't want to give away.
Yeah, I think we're going to explore them hopefully in the near future. But Kamal, so I met Kamal in Los Angeles back in 2012, and when I came back to New York City, he had given me a call and he offered me a small role in his film called Laugh, Kill a Laugh. Mm-hmm. And we formed a friendship as well as a working relationship. And I tell you, like, the guy is a genius, you know, directing, his writing. And I thank him for giving me the opportunity across the board because, you know, he really trusted me with this character. Mm-hmm. And the funny thing about it, about 2 months before we started shooting, he had given me a call, and I was walking out of my neurosurgeon's office, and I just right before that, I think about 2 weeks before that, I had brain surgery.
Oh my goodness!
And yes, and he had called me up, and he's like, "Hey, I got a part for you, and what do you think?" And I was like, "I just want to let you know, I just had brain surgery about 2 weeks ago, wow. And I want the part, and if you trust me, I'll make it happen." And he was like, I got to think about this. And I was like, yeah, dude, yeah. I can do it. And he gave me the opportunity, and I had a lot of fun doing it. It was rough sometimes, you know, but with his guidance, I got myself there, and I'm very proud of what we did.
That's awesome. Yeah. I mean, he gave you a chance. You were in recovery from this very serious surgery. I mean, brain surgery. That's very serious. Yeah. You know, a director could say, hey, you know, you just had surgery. Why don't you take 6 months off? I'll find somebody else to take your part or what. But he was, open-minded enough to, give you that chance, even though you just went through such a, you know, traumatic experience.
Cool. So I can't thank him enough. I really couldn't.
Nice.
We're so happy that you're okay.
Yeah, I mean, that's a lot to go through. Yes. So it's good to see that. Yeah, I mean, you look great, and that's a wonderful recovery. So, you know, Godspeed.
Yes, thank you. That's excellent. James, what's up, buddy?
Yes. James, hey, how's it going? So James, I don't know you too well. I don't think we've met before, but tell me just a little bit about yourself.
And, I know Kamal an awfully long time. We worked on a film together back in the 90s called The Jerky Boys.
I've heard of that one.
Oh, yes.
I remember playing the cassette tapes in, like, my Toyota Corolla back in, I don't know, late 80s, early 90s. Laughing my ass off.
Listening to them. They were hysterical. So, yeah. And then we formed a friendship just like he did with Joe. And through the years, you know, we've worked on different things. And he gave me an opportunity to do something a lot different than I normally get a chance to. I would never get a role like this in you know, like a commercial project, as they say. So I'm very grateful for that opportunity.
Excellent. And tell us a little bit about the role that you're playing on the show.
Interesting character. His name is Darrin. And I don't know how to really describe it, except that he's being manipulated by outside sources through his television and through the radio. He's sort of being used to commit a murder, to murder a scientist.
Right. And we don't want to give too much away.
What's that?
We don't want to give too much away.
Well, it wasn't the brother that committed the murder. It was the uncle.
Wait, I'm not saying a word here.
Don't give away the surprise ending. That's what they should say.
Yeah.
Well, yeah, so
it just sounds like the show's got a lot of different layers to it. So I'm really looking forward to some of the other ones. I'm
sorry to be ahead of that.
So Stuart Rudin, I heard that you were in a movie called Silence of the Lambs, right? And everybody kind remembers.
I'm not going to give it away.
Stuart was Hannibal Lecter's neighbor in the prison. So
I didn't have a shot.
So I think you could fill in the blanks if you ever saw some of those scenes. What was going on?
Multiple MIGs.
Yeah,
that's what this character. Multiple MIGs.
The less you say, I find is better for me.
So. Awesome. And in Crash the System, what are you playing? What are you playing in that?
I play much less than I say, you know. I do much more than I say, I should say.
All right, and we have another clip that we're going to watch from Crash the System. This one is starring Stuart Rudin over here. You play Yanos Topos in there. So, Stuart, tell us a little bit about this scene.
Okay, what you're looking at now is Gemini, the character, and he's about to come up and meet me for the first time. And it's somebody who is who he's kind of working for.
Okay.
And kind of
not sure what's
doesn't
going on.
Know who he's working for, right?
Okay, so it's more like a revelation and a meeting.
Yeah, he sort of comes together with me and I come together with him, and we're copacetic.
Nice. And we also have Joey on this scene as well, who joined us earlier on the Zoom call. And I just wanted to mention that this is on IMDb, and it has a 9.4 rating, which is higher than Game of Thrones and Better Call Saul. So, you know, it's got to be good. So please watch it. All right, let's take a look at the scene here.
Hello, Gemini. I'm Trevor. Mr. Topos is waiting your arrival.
Mr. Topos, I can't believe it was you that I was doing jobs for.
No one ever does. That was a brilliant plan you came up with.
Thank you, Mr. Topos.
Our goal is to spread awareness of the struggles of minorities, migrants, women, gays, and the poor. Your assassinations are an important part of this goal. I'd like you to stay on board.
You really want to know why I killed them? Because they got more hateful than the things they hated. And I couldn't deal with that. So I played God. But I'm not God. I feel like it sometimes. When I got the power of life and death over someone in my crosshairs. But I shouldn't. I never realized how much power corrupts the soul.
Gemini, you know who wins when two groups of people on opposite ends of the spectrum go to war against each other?
No, who?
The Coffin Maker. I know you killed him, and I want you to kill others next.
Why?
Because people are only meant to see a tree, not the roots, which are far underneath the surface.
And what's underneath the surface here?
Something I'm not at liberty to discuss with you, because quite frankly, it would be too mind-boggling for you to accept. Trevor will show you how.
Well, a lot of seriousness going there, you know, a lot of drama happening. And the acting, I mean, you know, it's tense. Yeah. You could feel the tension in the car there. So that's awesome. So great job on that. All right, and we have a scene that we're going to watch right now of Crash the System. So we're going to take a look. So, Cory, why don't you set this up? What are we going to be watching over here?
Well, you know, he's at his little, it seems like it's his regular spot. And there's people in his group that he has. He has a sort of a, I don't want to say specifically what religion, but he has like sort of, it almost is like a circle of people. And it's almost like an AA meeting, but people just need, he sort of leads this sort of a spiritual, semi-Christian And so he's done one of those, and now he's just chilling by himself. But a couple of people from the congregation are now showing up.
Okay,
with
all
some
right.
news.
Let's take a look at Crash the System.
Oh my God, Raymond, can we sit down?
Sure. Slowly.
We love the work you do at the center. You know, with people who hit hard times and all.
Thank you. I'm no different from anybody there. Okay, we're just all lost souls looking for the light.
That's what we're trying to tell you. We both kind of had a religious experience tonight, and we need someone to talk to.
Sure, I'm all ears.
Okay. We work at this club in the city. We're strippers, just so you know. Exotic dancers.
Look, I'm not here to judge.
We know, that's why we need to talk to you. See, we got tired of getting ripped off from our manager.
Oh, God, that is such an exploitative job where you've got to deal with the most desperate men coming in there, you know. They must have you shaking your naked bodies, you know, on the stripper pole and twerking. Jane, I can't even continue to talk about it, please. Go on.
We got ripped off by the manager, and we, killed him.
You what?
Well, Laura hit him over the head with an ashtray, and I took all the money.
He's dead.
Well, I mean, he was making sounds, so I think probably he's still alive. He looked dead to me. But anyway, what do we do?
Hold on. You took his money. You hit him on the head, and you took his money. How much was it?
Like, 4,000.
Are you sure he was still making sounds and he was still moving?
Yeah, but what do we hit him? Raymond, what do we do? What do we do?
I mean, what you did was irresponsible.
Raymond, what do we do? What do we?
I mean, you're facing a whole bunch of criminal charges. You're talking about felony assault, robbery, attempted murder.
Shit.
Okay, you're going to jail.
No.
You guys are going to jail.
I don't want to go to jail.
No.
I don't want to go to jail.
Well, look, as luck would have it, I know a captain, okay, the local precinct right up here. He's one of our parishioners, all right? It's a long story. I could tell him your side of the story and tell him how sorry you are.
Yes.
You know, but what happened to the manager? You should probably give me the money so that I can give it to the police first. You got to get ahead of these things and be first.
Okay. Raymond, just take it. Yeah.
So yeah, I like that scene. I got to tell you, Corey. You know, glasses and a beard. I mean, you're sitting here. I don't even think it's the same person. So
right.
I mean, you really, you know, got a character going on there. You know, different than the real Corey. You know, and Kathleen, you were in that scene as well, right?
Oh yes.
Yeah, that was a good one. Anything you want to add to that, or
just way too trusting from this one over here?
Yeah,
like
yeah.
He's like just sitting there in his essence, his element of just ripping people off, and we're here.
Yeah.
What should we do? And he's just like,
you're so trusting. And you could tell that he's like, he's got a lot going on behind those eyes, you know?
And I'm just so clueless. I've got everything he's scheming about, but it was fun doing that.
You could definitely tell there's a lot of scheming going on behind those glasses, though. And we're going to see more of that as the series progresses as well. Excellent. So tell me about your role in the TV show. What do you play?
I play Magda. She is a character. I think that she too definitely lives a life of lies. I think that she presents herself one way when she's completely the other. She's very deceptive. But I think, I don't want to give too much away, but I think that most of her choices that she's made in life are because of things that have happened to her.
Mm.
I think that she's a character that has a lot of emotional baggage.
Mm.
She's very well written. It was really a pleasure to play her.
Mm-hmm.
But she certainly can be very deceptive. And I think when reading the script, it's sort of like, you know, Cory is like the first person that she didn't really want to be deceptive with, but she was sort of forced to by the circumstance that she was in. I think that, again, without giving too much away, I think that she just is someone who really looked to Cory's character for
some sort of guidance or anything like
that. Guidance, support, friendship. And I think that as much as she sort of loves her power trip that she sort of just exists in, I think that she certainly was a little bit hurt when she had to do what she did.
Excellent, excellent. All right, well, thank you. Please watch Crash the System on Amazon Prime and Tubi. And I want to thank everybody again for coming. It was a great, great time. I'm glad you took some time out to come and visit me. And we're going to check out that show right away. All right, excellent. Thank you very much.
Greetings to all you sheep that live in the Meadowbrook of Life. I am the savior of all of you. We live in a system. It's called society. Within the society, it has its checks and balances to keep the people in place. The system likes law and order because that's what they've been told to like by the system. That's what the true nature of religion is. To set these rules in a celestial tone, then have the system extend them to an earthly tone. But has anyone ever asked themselves, what would happen if the system was crashed? If we just said, we don't need you. Most would think anarchy would take over. And people lose their life, property, and freedom. People think this way because the system made them believe this. Made them believe all humanity is evil and violent if law and order were to collapse. But this law and order was brought on by the people who want to control the world and keep the people in the dark. They want to control our true nature and destroy the earth for money. They want to extract every last ounce of silver, gold, platinum, and oil from the ground till we're a barren wasteland. You see this guy? You may not know who he is, but pretty soon after my work, you will. He may seem unimportant to you, but he's not. He's part of the system. He's part of the problem. He works for the giants that control us little people. And there's only one way to slay a giant, by attacking low and working your way to the top. I do this because it all has to stop. And I will do my best to crash the system. This is Gemini. Peace out, brothers and sisters.